Now the temperature is increasing, the voltage are increasing. With the ambient temperature, with the room temperature, it will change the voltage value. The same voltage value is going to the microcontroller. Friends, welcome back to my channel. This is inverter AC, indoor unit board, 1.5 ton Gree AC. How this temperature sensor works in the indoor unit board? Either it is split unit, either it is inverter AC, whatsoever. This is a question from my viewer. Explain the temperature sensor track in AC PCB. I mean, I deadly need to know what happens when the temperature sensor gives a signal to processor. How many voltage get out from the sensor? And where did it go? Yes, it is a really very nice question. Thanks for writing. Either you have SMPS low voltage power supply, or you have transformer based power supply, there will 5 volt regulator. Closer to that 5 volt regulator, there is 5 volt capacitor. If you see here, here is 12 volt capacitor. The same voltage from this capacitor are reaching here. Center pin is ground. This is output pin. Closer to output pin, there is this capacitor. This capacitor, positive side is here. Let me turn on multimeter. This point, it is reaching here. 5 volt from here to this jumper. This one, then it will reach here, here, and it is reaching at this point. So 5 volt positive will reach here to the one end of one sensor and one end of the second sensor. Both sensors will receive 5 volt signal. Positive 5 volt. It is reaching to this NTC. In some units there is NTC and in some units there is PTC. It is 14.47 kilo ohm. It is around 25 degrees centigrade. When the temperature will increase, now I will touch it. When the temperature will start to increase, its resistance will decrease. The resistance is decreasing with relation to temperature. When I will leave it, the resistance will go back to normal. It is a negative temperature coefficient. This thermistor is negative temperature coefficient, that when the temperature will increase, its resistance will decrease. When the temperature will decrease, its resistance will increase. Let's check the other one. This one 15 kilo ohm. That is room temperature sensor, ambient temperature sensor. And this is tube temperature sensor, the black one. Let's check its type. It is 20 kilo ohm. Now I will touch it. It is also NTC. When its temperature is increasing, its resistance is decreasing. So both sensors are NTC type, negative temperature coefficient. This one have 15 kilo ohm. This is ambient temperature sensor. it is connected in this way here. The second sensor is 20 kilo-ohm. That is tube temperature sensor, cooling sensor. It is also receiving 5 volt from this capacitor. The second end of first sensor when it is connected, 5 volt will go into sensor, then it will come back to this point. And if we check this point here, it is connected here at this point, at this point, 9.4k. but if we check it is 19.8k, that's 20 kilo ohm resistance. This resistance is 20 kilo ohm. Parallel there is a capacitor and this end is grounded. This end is connected to this ground. Positive voltage are reaching at this point and ground is reaching to this resistor. Now we can say this 20 kilo ohm sensor is connected to an other resistance. It is grounded. In parallel there is a decoupling capacitor. And if we check from the same point, it is connected to this point. Three components in parallel: this first capacitor, resistor, and this component. It is polar capacitor. Polar capacitor second end is also connected to ground. That is this capacitor 1 and 2. If it is connected in this way, so this capacitor for this network 25 volt 10 microfarad. After that, from this point, then it is connected to this resistor. It is 470 ohms, and second end of this resistor is coming to this point of microcontroller. Now the circuit is very clear. We provided 5 volt here to this voltage divider network. It is fixed value resistance. Its resistance is changing with change in temperature. At 25 degree it will give some equal resistance. We can say at 25 degree it will provide 2.5 volt. Let's assume that it is 20 kilo ohm. It is 20 kilo ohm. When 20 kilo ohm, here we will receive 2.5 volt. The value may differ with change in temperature. Let's check the second side. The second sensor, this point, same here, one capacitor, second capacitor here, and we have this resistance, that is 470 ohm, the same network. Let's check the value of this resistance. It is 15 kilo ohm. Upside 20 kilo ohm, here 15 kilo ohm, and this resistor 471. From this end of this resistor, it is reaching to this pin, and this end is reaching to this pin. So microcontroller analog pin will receive voltage. If I will set temperature to 20 degree, what will happen? I transmitted a digital format value through this IR to the microcontroller, and microcontroller converted this value into some code. We can say that is 24H, for example. Now this value, our required value from microcontroller analog signal, here is A to D converter. It will give value here. That value will translated value of this temperature. For example, it is 23H. Then processor will, microcontroller will take these two values, A minus B. So it will take difference between these two values. If we are requiring 20 degree and here is 25 degree or some any value, it will decide that our required value is less than this ambient temperature. For example, room temperature is 25 degree and we demanded 20 degree. That means there is 5 degree temperature difference. So then there is defined window. I requested 20 degree. It will say 20 plus minus 1, 19 to 21 degree. It is example. If our present value is out of this limit, it will turn on the compressor. Compressor will start, it will start cooling. When it will start cooling, at that time, this value will change and it will monitor all the time. It will keep monitoring this value. When this value, our required value and present value will come in this window here, it will turn off the compressor. It started compressor and it will keep monitoring this value as well. The same process. It will wait, for example, 6 minutes. If within 6 minutes its tube temperature starts to decrease, that means the cooling process is started. That means the outdoor unit is working and cooling is leaking here. If it is not finding any response on this temperature, it will generate error code. It will receive temperature. That temperature will change its resistance. Its resistance will change its value. For example, at 25 degree, it was providing 2.5 volt, but when the temperature is decreasing, the voltage are now 2.4 volt, 2.2 volt. So this value will determine the temperature difference. There is programming in the microcontroller that if it will find 2.2 volt at this pin, this analog pin, that will equal to 20 degree. For example, let's apply power and let's monitor the voltage. If you don't have good practical experience in electronics, never do this experiment, never try to repair, because it has live voltage. I'm applying power using series lamp. Line here, neutral here. First we will monitor the voltage at this capacitor. Let's check voltage here is regulator, and immediately after regulator we have 5 volt here. The same 5 volt are applied at this terminal and second side of this resistor network. We have 5 volt, and if we check output pin of the sensor and the ground pin, it is 2.6 volt. We have 2.6 volt output of the sensor, and these voltage are reaching across this capacitor, polar capacitor. This polar capacitor will provide smooth increase in the voltage, and the same voltage value is going outside from this resistor, that is 470 ohms. Now I am holding this thermal sensor, temperature sensor, and we can see the voltage are increasing. Now the temperature is increasing, the voltage are increasing. If it is using NTC, if it is using PTC, here voltage will drop. But it also matters on the combination, how the circuit is configured. If this NTC is connected in low side or upside, the scenario will change. But we need to understand the voltage divider network, how it is changing. Let's check the second one. The same here, this sensor, 2.61 volt. Now I will hold it. You can see with the ambient temperature, with the room temperature, it will change the voltage value. The same voltage value is going to the microcontroller. When we will turn it on or turn off, it will monitor these voltage and it will compare with this reading. When I freed these sensors, now the voltage are returning back. The first most common failure, these capacitors. If these capacitors are devalued, these will not allow to hold the charge. In result, the processor cannot decide what is the exact temperature now. And sometimes these small capacitors that are connected in parallel to this resistor here and here, these become short circuit. If it is short circuit, what will happen? It will discharge these voltage directly and it will not allow to charge this capacitor. So microcontroller will not take accurate value, because in that case microcontroller pin will connect it to ground, easiest path. And sometime this NTC thermistor is bad, at that time it will not work properly. So we can monitor the resistance and we can monitor the voltage as well. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.